Hey guys, Hanzo here, and welcome to the brand new walkthrough for Resident Evil 6. Now, I've actually completed all the campaigns already on my own time, so I think it's time to start the walkthrough for it. Let's increase the brightness a little bit, because it tends to look darker on YouTube. Now, I'll be doing the entire walkthrough on the normal difficulty, mainly because I am not good enough to do veteran or professional. I will most likely die a lot if I did that. Now, this game got mixed reviews, some good, some bad, but mostly bad. And in my opinion, it's not a bad game, it just didn't live up to the title as well as it should have. But overall, I still liked it. Talk about starting a game with a bang, eh? We don't know what that's going on. But technically this is the prologue. You get to pick which campaign you want to do. And we get to start out the prologue with Leon. And if you're wondering, no, I am not a big Leon fan.
Come on. It's not over
yet. I don't hate him, it's just that my favorite Resident Evil character is not him. Let me just quickly turn on some subtitles here first. Game, screen, game. Oh, there it is. First one. Turn on, please. There you go. Okay, how do I use this? Okay. That's what I'm saying, no, Leon is not my favorite character in the series.
Hang in there, Helena.
Smooth, Leon, smooth.
I'll only slow you down. Just go.
You're not getting off that easy. Come on.
As I mentioned before, this is just a prologue before the game actually starts.
After all we've been through, it'd be a waste to give up now.
Now this game is filled with action sequence button pressing, so always pay attention to the screen, even during cutscenes. In my opinion, I actually don't like these. Because it takes attention away from the cutscene itself, because you have to pay attention. can't really enjoy the cutscene. Come on, Helena. You're very heavy. What's that? Is it a zombie? Why am I whispering?
Let's try this way.
Okay, at least, Helena, if you can't walk, at least pull out a gun. It makes me feel a lot better if you did have a gun out. But the soldier is dead. I say dead because he's definitely dead.
Let's take a break.
We didn't go very far.
There's gotta be a first aid kit in here somewhere.
Let's find a healing item so that Helena can stop, you know, dragging us down.
Makes me sick seeing good soldiers die like this.
There is some herbs. The stable healing item in Resident Evil games. I'll take that.
Leon, are you there?
Hunnigan.
Good to hear you're okay. Where's Helena?
She's not doing too good. She needs medical attention.
Do you have any herbs left?
A few, but I'm not sure they'll help.
Okay, listen. Just follow my instructions.
So we're gonna get a tutorial on how to use items and combine items and to heal your allies.
Hold on, Helena. Too many good agents have died here today. You're not getting added to that list.
Leon.
Is there a reason why I didn't pull my gun out earlier? Okay, I'm headshotting you. More quick time events. Seriously, Helena, I know you're down, but you could at least do something. Never mind, I got it.
Can't let your guard down for a second.
I should just lie there the whole time. Alright, here, take some drugs.
How do you feel?
I think I'm gonna be okay. Thank you.
Leon, what are you doing? You need to get out of there, now!
We're heading to the Quad Tower.
What? No, it's too dangerous.
There are BSAA agents there with survivors. I can't abandon them.
All right. Then let me help. I'll direct you through the safest route.
Thanks, Hunnigan.
All right.
I've sent over the field guide to your PDA. You can always refer to that in a pinch.
And hold L2, and it will just tell you which way to go. So you shouldn't technically get lost in this game.
What the hell?
Roger.
Helena.
Hunnigan, can we make it to the tower this way?
Yes, just keep moving in that direction.
Yeah, of course, it's chaotic outside. Alright. Let's fight some zombies. Oh, hello. Ooh, ammo. As you can tell, I'm one of those players in Resident Evil that likes to stun the zombie and then finish them with a melee attack. Because it does save a lot of ammo. Or you can be like Helena and just kick them in the face. Oops. Okay, get out, you stupid zombie. And boom. Ooh, shotgun shells. Oh, that's right. Helena has a shotgun right now. Ow!
They're coming out of the woodwork!
Okay, don't leave. You learn the quick shot ability, you press aim and shoot at the same time. But it requires stamina to perform.
Run!
Time to go! Where's Helena? Is she in front of me? I hope she's in front of me. What happened to that soldier? We just leave him?
Shit.
Sorry, no tiger, dude. Get off me, please. Trying, Helena.
Come on, pull up.
This thing isn't gonna hold up much longer.
Just a few more blocks.
Helena, it's a zombie.
Helena!
I'm gonna shoot and drive at the same time. Just missed it. Again. Uh-oh.
Shit! Hold on!
Definitely do not want to go down there, but you, what I mean with the cutscenes, you have to like suddenly press buttons. It kind of ruins the cutscene, in my opinion. I like how it interacts with us, but I don't like it.
Something doesn't feel right.
Jump down here.
Back for more.
And that is the end of the prologue sequence of the game. So now you can decide which campaign you want to do, but at the beginning you can always choose between Leon, Chris, or Jake.
Resident Evil.
I haven't decided who I'm going to start with. But yeah, so thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and we'll officially start the walkthrough next time.